Hey guys, this is Poet Spice, and I thought I would just come along here and do a little haul video. I've gotten in some books over the last several weeks, and some of them I've already done flip throughs, but I didn't do like necessarily a collective haul kind of thing. So I'm just going to do that real quick, and then you can see the ones I did flip throughs of. You can also go to Instagram and see some that have pages, completed pages. I haven't been doing those videos either, but... and some color alongs and so forth. So I'm just going to go ahead and get started. Like I said, these have been over the last several weeks. So one is Sweet Fantasy, and I did do a flip through of this book, and it is a German author. What is her name? Oh, I don't remember her name. It's Lee something, I think, or something like that. But I did do a flip through, so you can see the flip through on my channel. And I did a coloring. I had people vote. And so this was, see if I can move out for you a little bit. This was the color along that I did for my hot guy summer. Yeah. So that was one. And then I had others. So you can see this one. It's got very dark grayscale in it. And of course, black backgrounds, and I absolutely love it. And I can still do this one for this hashtag, because I got two hashtags going on September and October. One is Steampunk Masquerade for Poet, and that is anything steampunk, carnival masks like Mardi Gras, plus steampunk obviously, and then like costumes. So if you got like a Halloween costume party thing going on, and pumpkins, so anything that falls in that. So steampunk, definitely loving. And there's some more. So yeah. There's a full flip for this one. I could even get away with doing this one for steampunk. And then, of course, my second one is Pirates for Poet, because, hello, September 19th is Talk Like a Pirate Day, which I'm thinking of getting stuff ready for my class so we can do a pirate theme thing. Excuse me. I have a cold, so. I did a flip through of this one, which is by the same author. It's AI as well. And I believe when I was looking at this, they said that the author does like editing of the AI. But these were both on Amazon. And so I liked some of these. They were interesting to do. So this could be like steampunk, even though this is more biomech. So you could do that. Yeah. So I haven't colored anything in this one yet, but I thought this was cute. Interesting. Something different. I don't do a lot of anime, so it's like, okay. Next, I do Dominions of Giants, and I do have a flip through of this. Okay. And so we've got all these fabulous creatures. So, won't necessarily work for my hashtags, but oh well, actually this one will. Because there's a big old pirate boat. So I could do that one. And so, yeah. But I did get this and do this one for Hot Guy Summer. Yeah, it was supposed to be a Betty Color with Pixie, but I don't know if she ever did hers, so I don't know. But yeah, I'm kind of like doing the whole reset on Betty Colors. Pixie was talking about that in her video, so I finished a bunch of them, and then the other ones I'm just not doing, and so it's like reset. And then I do have a buddy color scheduled with Kitten Caboodles, but I don't know if we're actually still going to do it. So, I don't know. All right, so Fairy Homes and adult coloring, and this was Jade Summer. I don't know if I did a flip through. I know I did a post about it because Jade Summer had been off of Amazon. Just like Coco Wild had been taken off. And so... when I saw this one, I was like, what? It's back on? So I think I did do a flip through because these are looking familiar. But then that doesn't mean anything either because, you know, hey, sometimes I forget. And it looks like some of these are repeating. Like, it looks like this frog was earlier. Yeah. So it has a background and then a light background. But I don't think every image does this. I think some of them do, but not all of them. Yeah. I wanted to do this for my sweet sea summer, but I didn't get to. Oh, you can't see a darn thing with these dang lines. Sorry about that. I was looking at the book and not the camera screen. But yeah, so there's that one. Fairy Homes. Then, most of these are on Amazon. And then this one was Magical Earth. And I believe I got this one on... I might have gotten it on Amazon, but it was like a really good deal. Oh my gosh. I'm going to have to do it like this. Maybe I can do that because of the stupid blinds. But it was a really good deal. It was like at least half price. You know what I mean? It was at least that much off. And so I was like, when it came out, I was like, meh. But I still liked several pictures in here. But I wasn't really wanting to pay full price when I was only like me over most of them. But then, you know, at half price, I'll pay that. So, yeah. So I did get Magical Earth. And I want to say I got that on Book Outlet. I did do a post of this on Instagram. I am not sure if I did a flip through or not. Because I bought this, let me see, I got this one sent to my brother's house when we were in Texas to visit him. So, I don't know. So, this was the second googly book. And it's so pretty. And I've been wanting it and wanting it. And I was just like, yeah, I did not buy it. And then it was at a decent price and fast shipping. And I was just like, screw it. I'm just going to go ahead and get it. Now you can see all my crafting. Well, not even all of it, but a bunch of crafting crap up there. And it has these posters of the images. So it's really cool. And the paper's thick. The bad thing is it's double-sided. So... you know, like this one I could go ahead and color because, and then I don't know if I would do alcohol markers anyway, because this type of paper tends to drink the ink, but I could at least do alcohol markers on that piece, but not on the pages that are double-sided. All right, I bought this one because I've been wanting to buy one of these Momo Girl books, and I finally broke down, and I don't know. I guess I just get in these moods, and I'm like, screw it, whatever. So I went ahead and got it, and I like that they have some of the images colored in the front, and then you can see the images. I thought I had a buddy color in here. But I don't think I did. I think it's a different book. But, and then I will say this. There are some other ones of these, and some of the pictures cross over. Like, this picture right here is in at least two of the books by this author, because I've seen it. And I was like, I don't want doubles. I'm not a big fan of doubles. Unless I messed up the other one, then I'm like, dang, I wish I had a double. But, you know. Not really a big fan. So, I like this. And once again, it's double-sided. So, if you're going to... you can use alcohol marker if you're going to sacrifice. But... and you know me. I'm not above sacrificing a page. If it's one I want. Alrighty then. Let's go with these. So, Autumn Scenes. I got this one. This Teresa Goodrich. And, you know, we've all seen hers. I like her little images. They're so cute. I like the little sketchiness that she has to them. And I like how she makes her little people and they actually fit into the background. Well, not that one, but I wouldn't color it up anyway. But you know, like the little people, they fit into the background and it just looks so cute. See? Oh, y'all. So adorable. So I got that one. Then I did get this one, which is Mardell Rubio. I have his Serena book that I've had for years. It was one of the first adult coloring books I ever bought. And then I was looking at some other ones. And this one was on Amazon and it was like 10 bucks. But I did not realize it was going to be on this Amazon paper. And it looks a little sketchy. I don't know. So it doesn't have the same quality on the paper that it did before. And I don't know that I like all these images. I don't know if you can see them again. So some of them I do, some of them I don't. But, you know, that's typical. So, yeah. So if you get this book, the lines are not as, like, it's looking pretty crisp and sharp up here on the computer screen. But they're not really. They remind me of, oh, that one author. I can't think of her name. Oh, but I got rid of all, well, I'm getting rid of all her books because I don't like the way they look. Okay, then, of course, I got 50 Space Theme miniatures. And these are just way too adorably cute. Like, what? Why? Why are they so cute? I don't know, but they are. And, of course, I haven't colored in it at all yet. It's like once work starts back up for the school year, it's like I have less time, less energy. So, and then I have a cold, so that's not helping either. I'm hoping it's just a cold because good Lord. All right, let's do. All right, since I did those before, let's do these books. Okay, so this was basically a blind buy. It's a group of cats on a pirate ship, and of course, I purchased it because I thought it was cute. It's cats, it's pirates, like, what would not be cute about that? But unfortunately, and I saw the little back designs, and I thought that was cute, because it kind of gives me, you kind of get like an old feel, but kind of more of a modern feel, and an old feel, so it's kind of like that in-between genre, not genres, but in between eras kind of thing. So a little bit of this with a little bit of that. So I thought it was really cute. And they look really cute, right? Some of them are adorable. And yeah. So number one, it's AI. And it's not even edited AI. So that was disappointing. So it teaches me I really shouldn't do too many blind buys, which I don't. I tried to find it flip through, but there wasn't anything on it. So some of them are okay. Like this one is okay. But then look at this one. So here's the cat's one arm. Here's the cat's other arm. Why does it have a third arm where it shouldn't be? Like, he wouldn't be, he's not sitting, he's standing. So there's an arm that shouldn't be there. And then this arm should have the jacket on it and it doesn't. Yeah, so I was disappointed that it is definitely AI and they didn't bother to check it because there are some crazy, I'm gonna see if I can find some other ones. There are some crazy, like this, what's going on here? It looks like animal feet at the bottom, but then, like, what is that? I don't understand what that is. So, I'm not sending it back because it wasn't that expensive, and there are some that are still cute. Like, look at this one. So, here's a, I'm gonna say his hand. Here's a hand, here's a hand, there's a foot. Doesn't that look like it should be, like, his haunches? So, where's the other foot? So, if I color this, I'll have to do it so that it looks like a foot. See, but then all this is cute. So, I was kind of disappointed that there were several that were like that. That you could tell it was AI. But, That was after I bought it. Like here. He looks deformed. He's got one hand, and then there's another hand. And he wouldn't be, it's not like he would be his foot, which is what it looks like, because he's standing up cooking. So did he chop his foot off and put it on the table? I don't know. Yeah. So I guess if I colored those, I'd probably end up putting some like mixed media stuff over it. You know, like, I don't know, flour or something. And then same thing here. Like, his toes wouldn't be right there. So yeah, it was kind of disappointing. But you can see how the rest of it's so cute. It's like, oh my gosh. So there you go. I'll quit belaboring the point. All right, then the next thing I got, because this looked interesting. I can't remember whose channel I saw it on. I know I commented on their channel when I looked at it, but I don't remember who, because I tend to watch a lot of videos at one time. So this is anime and manga coloring book for teens and adults. And there's a bunch of these with the same name, but different covers. And so they have like different images in them. But I liked this one and thought I would try this one to see. And so it has some really cool images. And they look pretty much like they were fixed up, you know. I didn't see too many like overly weird things sticking out or doing weird stuff. So I'm wondering if they did AI and then edited it. Because there's no like extra, and there might be a couple little things, and of course you've got like the mix of different flowers with different line weights, but, and once again, it may look, I don't know, it may, like during the, in the camera, it looks like these lines are very sharp and crisp, but they're not. They've got that fuzzy look to them. So you got that again. So I was like, but I'll try it, see what it's like. And I really like the cover, the way the cover feels. It's one of those like suede-y covers. I don't know. I just love those. Okay. Then I don't remember who this was, but they posted in my Hot Guy Summer. And I was like, oh, I must find that book. And then I was like, hey, whatever. What volume was it? So it is Preston Potpourri is what it looks like. I don't know if that's how he's pronouncing it, but Potpourri is what it looks like. Potpourri. And so it is definitely a weird book. This is volume one. So it has some, the only thing I don't like about this one is the fact that there is a lot, it's got a lot of heavy darks in it, which, see how much dark there is? And so that's not always the best. That reminds me of the Shel Silverstein. He's like, Dan, the world's dirtiest man. That's what that reminds me of. But see, there's so much dark. Especially for a coloring book. And then you got stuff like that, which is crazy. So it's so fun. It's like a weird mix of ridiculousness. So hilarious. So it's just creepy weird and whatnot. I think what I'll do is I'll do a total flip through of this, because you got to see it. Just it's crazy. So then I bought them at the same time, so these were pretty much a blind buy other than the, now, I think there were some flip throughs, but I think I just bought the two. So this is the one where, from the person who participated in my Hot Guy Summer. So, because this is volume three. And so it's like, this is funny. So you could see once again, and it's just crazy because you got these weird looking line art pieces like this. And then you've got these simple ones. And then you've got this heavy cross hatching and lining and all that kind of stuff. So they're just weird.
Like, why he got this big eye? And why is he looking like that? I don't know. But it's just crazy. It's a randomness. This one just reminds me of this, like, hot mess randomness. But it's so funny. So, and this picture right here is creepy and hilarious. It's like, why? Why are you so weird looking? Yeah, so I'll do separate flip throughs of those, I guess, because they deserve their own. All right, then I picked up this Bells and Blossoms from Creative Haven. And when I saw the flip through, which I can't remember whose channel I saw it on, I was like, oh, this is cute. And then when I got it home, I was like, eh, it's all right. I don't know. You know how that is. You see a book and it's like, oh yeah, that would be fabulous. And then you get it and you're like, eh, wah, wah. So I'm kind of wah, wah about this one. But it is what it is. Okay. Now, I think I showed this one because I did a buddy color in here. But I don't know if I actually put it in a haul video. So here it is. 50 Vacation Summer Fairy Houses. And I did, I think, the one with Pixie. Which is funny because this would work for Olga Ronnie's challenge this week. And I had some others that I wanted to do for my Sweet Sea Summer. Like this one. And clearly, it's not done. No. Just because, no, I didn't get it done. All right, then, this is definitely because of Pixie. She was doing, what is that book's name? Aria Vale. Complete that book. But I didn't really like that book. I mean, people did pretty pictures in it and stuff, like when they colored it. But it wasn't speaking to me. So, I didn't get that one. But she showed this one as the new book to replace Aria Vale, which is Cozy Spaces, Interiors, and Magical Places to Color. And she showed it in her last video. I don't remember if she picked a page for this month, but I thought it was a cute book. So it was on Amazon. So it's Amazon printed paper. It is single-sided. It's black-backed. And it's just inside spaces, which I do like. I don't know. I do like the little, where there's all these little things to color. Now, it still takes me an arm and a, forever and a day to do it, but I like it because it's just relaxing. And then you have, like, people doing things. And then, of course, they're books. So, you know, I'm like all about the books. 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 And I guess that's her phone. More books. Phone. Books. Phone, books, phone, books, phone, books. Which is so cute. And then I think I just, didn't I see a suitcase? So, I know the idea is to, excuse me. I know the idea is to color the pages as they're assigned. But you know, it's my coloring book. I can do what I want. So here's some suitcases too. So I might just go ahead and color in it anyway, because I'm that's me. If I feel like something I'm coloring and I want to color it, then I'm just gonna color it. Doesn't matter if it's Christmas in, you know, like October, or Halloween on January 1st, is whatever I feel like coloring. So I need to keep this handy somewhere so that at least I can attempt to do the page that she's assigned for the month. And then last but not least, like, although I don't have like two more books coming. Yeah. But they're not here. So last but not least, I finally broke down and bought the Dark Art Supernatural. I wasn't going to buy it. Because first of all, I haven't colored all the first two yet. I've colored something in each one of them, but not the whole thing. And so I broke down and bought it. And I actually started, I bought some something. What did I buy? I bought Black Widow pencils a while ago. And so I finally went and bought the, I didn't buy the Dragon set. I bought the Monarch set. Because I had the spiders, I had the cobras, and I had the scorpions in the dark and light skin colors. And then I saw a video where they were talking about the dragon ones, but they were talking about how the dragon ones have a lot of repeat colors in it. So I'm like, I don't need two of the same pencil. So I was playing in here, and I liked how the Black Widows worked on this paper. At least for me, because that's something else. Like, everybody colors differently and pressure and whatever. And so, you know, people say, well, I don't like this and I don't like that. I say I don't like this and I don't like that. But if you're watching a video, have to keep in mind that it's what that person likes, and how it works for them versus a universal, it's a terrible pencil, because it may not be. Like, I just saw a video where this woman was talking how about the best pencils under $30 are Crayola color pencils. And I'm like, no, not even. Those aren't the best ones. You know what I mean? So it's all depending on what you like, and it changes by paper. So, like, I didn't like Black Widows on several other books that I had, but I do like it in this one. Anyway, that's long-winded. So you could see where I was testing them out, and then I was just like, whatever. So I wanted to see what they would do. And then, so here's the image. You can see where I already marked some of them. Somebody is doing like a jar, color jars, hashtag. So I thought this would be fun, because there's a lot of creepiness. See, now we know the snake's got to go, right? So we chop its head off or something. And so, yeah. And so there's some of these pictures, I'm not going to color them. But I did start on this one, because what do you see right there? A pirate ship and a pirate head. So we know this is going for a poet. It's pirates. Pirates for poets, hashtag. So, and this is all Black Widows. So I'm loving it. Loving it. And I think this is smaller than the other ones. I don't know. I don't know where my other book is. It just seems like it's a shorter book. And I could be wrong. But yeah, so I started with my Black Widows, and I like it. I just keep doing little pieces here and there. So, yeah. Now, since I did do this, let me put this on here, my little piece. So when it's done, it'll have its little corner. And so what I've been doing is, any picture I finish gets the little corner, and then I'm going to have a big old huge long video at the end of the year with all the pictures, because I haven't been doing monthlies. So then the other two things that I bought were the Monarch Black Widows. And so I'll put a little image here. I just discussed those. And then I also bought the Nione, I think it's 100 piece or 120, I can't remember, watercolor pencils. And I'll put an image of that here. And I also bought a case to put them in. So those two I bought and swatched, and I have to say I love the Nione watercolor pencils. They are so fabulous, and I've been using those in my Camellia Daerco pop manga mermaid book. Love them. And I do have images over on Instagram where I used them. excuse me. So that is what I have gotten as far as coloring books go. And then I will have on my craft channel the monster haul that I did for that. So, thank you guys for watching. If you want to see any flip-throughs of anything else, or if you want a buddy color, because I think I only have two buddy colors. The one that I'm not sure if Kitten Caboodles and I are still doing, and Deb, and I have one in that Rubio book. And thanks for watching. I hope you guys are doing okay out there, and be safe, be blessed, and, you know, enjoy yourself, and don't put up with crap. Bye.